Hello there! Today we're going to talk about how can you switch off during the holidays. Do you have to switch off? Do you want to switch off? No matter what, that's where it will be about today, the weekly video. My name is Tineke Rensen from Powerful Business Academy, and I help self-employed businesswomen who do a lot on their own build a business and become a business owner and a leader with a team and double your business within a year as well. Now today we're going to talk about when you still do a lot on your own and if you want to go on holiday or if you want to switch off at the end of the year or no matter what. So first of all, I want to check in with you about what are your perceptions about having a business and going on holiday or closing during the holidays. Do you come from a corporate job where you had a team and everything was arranged and people took care of your work when you were on holiday and nobody bothered you about it? Well, if you start your business, that it's not going to be like that. But if that's still in the back of your mind, you are going to want to switch off, which is okay. I'm not saying you shouldn't. I'm just saying, how does it work here in your mind? Your partner, your family, your kids, the people you join with on holiday, they might think you need to switch off because they have perceptions and beliefs on how a holiday should be working out. So first of all, that is important. You have to find out, how do you feel about running a business and going on holiday? You feel stress because you might gonna lose clients because you might not respond. You fear of missing out on social media because you feel you have to respond. I'm not saying you shouldn't respond. I'm not saying you shouldn't do work during the holiday, but all of it is a matter of perception. Whatever you believe, that is how you're going to feel. I just did a Facebook Live and someone said she felt guilty going on holiday and switching off because she has a business. And why should you feel guilty about it? I don't feel guilty about it. My team is working next week, but I switch off. I'm not 100%. So for me, it's always I switch off for 80% and 20%. I still do my social media. I still do my email. Why? Because I don't want to do all of that when I get back home. And social media, all the momentum is gone. And my team still does little things on social media. They post, for example, but I do the comments. And that's just my choice. I don't feel bad about it, that I have to do it. No, I want to do it. And if I don't feel like doing it for a day, I don't. So that is my thermometer. How do I feel about it? If you feel you don't want to do it, don't do it. And then yeah, you might miss a client, but you also are totally shut off and you re-energize yourself. And if you feel I can't miss a client, I can't miss that money, then it's compression, it's pressure, it's stress, and you will not be relaxing. If you feel like me, like, hey, I'm okay with it, just to do a little bit because I don't want to have all that hassle when I get back, when I shut off 100%. And then the first 3-4 days, I'm that busy that all my relaxation of the past week is gone already. And I don't want that to happen. I can't say how you have to do it. It's all a matter of what you believe and how can you handle your emotions around that belief. Do you have fear of missing out? I can give you some tips. If you really believe you want to shut off during the holiday, give your phone to someone else. Because let your friends know, because then they can call someone else's phone, your kids or your husband when they really need you, or your friend. Put your laptop in a safe or in your car or whatever, if you don't want to use it. Yeah, so then you protect yourself. Tips to be able to go on holiday is automate and work ahead. Make sure that you have 1, 2, 3 weeks, no matter how long you go, content of social media. You can schedule everything ahead. You can put an automated response on your email so that people see, hey, she's not there. She won't be answering now. You might read it, but there's no need for you to answer because everybody has got that message. If you have a team, it's a good test for you to see what can they do without you. So it's all a matter of perception and also the perception of the people around you. I know when I was still married, for my husband, it was, if you have a holiday, you switch off completely. But hey, he was working in a company with 3,000 people. He had a team. Everybody took care of his stuff when he was gone. And I wasn't at that place. And it was not my belief. My belief is I always wanted to be there for my team. That was my belief at the time. I did not want them to go over a lot of shit and hassle if there were problems. Now I have a different team, I have a different business. There is a lot less at stake with my other business. If a bus was late, 40 people would be waiting somewhere and we would have 40 people calling and emailing and texting. Yeah, that's a different problem than when I now close a week and my clients know well in advance that I'm not there. My team knows well in advance. There's really not going to be major issues that need problem solving. So it depends also on the kind of business you have, on the level of the team you have, on the level of how automated your business is, and ultimately, what is your feeling and perception about it. Whenever you start to feel emotions as guilt, stress, should've, could've, shouldn't, then you need to look at your beliefs around it, because then you are doing things against what you want to. All right? And if you can just accept that you want to do some work during the holiday, it's fine. And you need to deal with what other people say about that. You know, if I go on holiday, they always know in the morning, 1 hour, I do my email and social media. Everybody knows. They can moan, they can complain, but I do get up early. So most of them are not even awake when I work. So I'm not bothering anybody. And I'm not bothering myself because the whole day I am totally free in my mind and I can be there. So ultimately, it's up to you how you perceive things, how you work around things. There's a lot you can prepare. And if you want to work or don't want to work, it's up to you. But make sure that your beliefs are correct. Now, if you want to see more of these videos, become a member of our YouTube channel, Powerful Business Academy. Do sign up. There's only one Powerful Business Academy, so you'll find us. There's lots of videos around this because we create videos every week. And if you really want to scale your business next year, 2022, why don't you schedule a quick 15-minute call with me? It's just to check each other out. It's for me to see, hey, do you have what it takes to be able to scale and double your business in a year, guaranteed, yes or no? I don't know. And you don't know, maybe. Or you might want to, but it's not according to my principles. I have no idea. So that's why I would love to have that call. So bye-bye for now. And I'm looking forward to inspire you again next week. Bye.